In this video, I will show you how to paint roses in 3 steps using Alla Prima method of painting. Hello, I'm Brianna West. If you are new here, make sure to click on the subscribe and bell buttons below to get notified when I post new painting videos. In step 1, I start the painting by making a grid with the lightest transparent color on my palette. Drawing a grid allows me to capture the image more accurately. You can see the gridded source image on the upper left corner of your screen. Transparent colors are applied with a mixture of linseed oil and gamsol. This is my favorite part of the painting, where I can apply the paint loosely with blurred edges. The purpose of the transparent layer is to cover the entire surface of the canvas with colorful patches of paint. This creates a slick surface and will allow the next layer of opaque colors to go on smoothly.
Travel far, now retreating. I've longed for this place, longed for this place for so long. Now I lay me down, I lay me down, I be long. In that breathing the air fresh from the blessed Midwest, I am held by the forest where I go for rest, and washed by the waters of Lake Michigan, and wherever I go, I will return again to my home, the blessed Midwest.
It is important to keep the color combinations interesting in this phase. For instance, I will put cooler colors next to warmer colors. For this painting, I'm using cooler transparent purple next to warmer transparent reds, or cooler blues next to relatively warmer purples. I also pay attention to the value relations, keeping light and dark values in the same areas as in the source image. In step two, I'm drawing back the main shapes of the image with the rubber tip tool. This step is optional and can be used if a more precise copy of the source image is desired. Leave a comment below if you are using similar method in your paintings. Values give depth to the painting. To achieve this, I make sure to have both the darkest darks and the lightest lights in my paintings. Edges also give an illusion of the depth in the painting. I make edges softer for the objects that are on the background, and harder and more pronounced for the objects that are in the foreground. In step 3, I start laying in opaque colors. In this phase of the painting, I focus on the shapes, values, brushwork, and edges. Combination of various abstract shapes create an interesting painting. I also look for opportunities to place light and dark shapes next to each other. Brushwork is highly individual for each artist, just like the handwriting. I tend not to blend when I apply paint on the surface because I like the look of individual brush strokes that make the painting look like a mosaic. Leave a comment below if you have a favorite style of brushwork. Thank you. If you like this video, please click on the like button and share with your artist friends who would like to see full-length painting videos. For aspiring artists, it is helpful to paint along because you can see how each phase of the painting is progressing. I post new painting videos weekly and share tips on various painting topics to help aspiring artists advance their painting skills quicker. Thank you. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon below and be notified when new videos are posted. Also, leave a comment below of the type of painting you would like to see. Click on the card on your screen to watch the next video.